Germany. 2016 or 2017. The new series, the 1990s. I could have said Germany, 1990. Boom. So, I did the T90s. Hated them. Couldn't stand them. I did the 990s, the predecessor to this. And I was just able to cope. It was like, all right, but not really in love. Then I did recently the T5Ps and the T1s. And I had these and the T1s at the same time. But I left these away because I didn't want to. The T1s are very good. Very good. And the 1990s here are right behind them. Beyerdynamic has finally decided, and I haven't heard the 1770s. Those got really crap reviews on Amazon. I'd love to know what those are about. If you have a set, think about sending me them. But the 1990s here are the open precision. Jesus, the precision on this build. All the laser cut holes and the inscribing and the cutting and the actually not that sharp edges on this. They've fixed their shit. And then you get the pads, and it comes with two pads, and it comes with balancer on it. And these are the analytical ones that have only four holes, and these have a ton of holes. And the cable is actually, look, wait, detachable with an AKG-style mini XLR, which means you don't have to use this retardedly long. It comes with, and this is how it originally came. I didn't unwrap this. This is the how the Germans wrap up your coiled cable. Like it's got AIDS. No, just tie this off in a completely hermetically sealed knot with tape around that and leave this, but these are exposed, that's fine. Oh, and this connector has plastic covering it because shiny plastic needs to be, I don't know, protected under the Nürburgring trial laws of whatever year. Oh yeah, you can't have that be exposed, God forbid. So yeah, oh, that's very, very protected. And here's the other cable, the one I actually had to take out. And it took weeks for this to straighten out. See how nice and straight it is? Look at the straightness on that. I had to drape it like over big, long things to get it to do this. And it's very usable. And it's okay. I like the feel. It's just very, very long. It's coming back to its roots now and being like that. So I bought this cable originally for the K712 is over there. It's like a 1.2 meter, which is 4 feet if you lame people, the lay person, yeah. And I've been using this on it, just because it's shorter. I won't put it on now, because we're doing the full review. I'm gonna do it with a stock cable, stock pads, although these are the different pads. So the two pads it comes with change the sound signature pretty actually significantly. And they look from the outside identical. But the balance that I come with are stiffer and have more holes. And the analytical, which are the ones that I changed out to, which they come in this beautiful bag. Hold on. Put these away. There we go. The analyticals I changed out to are softer. And I'll talk about the sound changes in a second. Let's finish gawking over that German build. Like Porsche, it's like, oh my god, Porsche, come to me, Porsche build. I've ripped those apart. And the inside of that gauge cluster, it was the nicest thing I'd ever seen. Ever. So I know the Germans are just, they can do it. And they've done it. They finally look. Beyerdynamic has had I've had a problem with them for a while. Their 770s good, then T90s and 990s. And it's worked up, and I've gotten, and now we're here. And although these aren't cheap, these aren't like an entry-level pair. These are $600. Actually, we'll go over the $600 versus the $529 bundle, which is ridiculous, and in a second. But there are no flaws in the build of this headphone. The stitching, it's the softness. The padding, the split on the bottom. It's all great. goes in the case. Look at the case. Holds it all beautifully. And it's got this bag that's Velcroed. It's attached, yet it's Velcroed for whatever reason. And this holds the extra wires. Put this one away, in fact. So you get this sack, and the sack goes in, and it closes, and it says Bear Dynamic Professional. And, shit, I should probably take this out to review. I've been using these as my regular headphones for like 2 weeks now. I have all these headphones out and those and just you know, Jotunheim on the extra setup. I'm just like, eh, I'll just use the 1990s. Those are the fine. They're fine. They're fine. They're just fine. They're better than fine. They're great. They have finally redeemed themselves. The only thing I would do is this is kind of stiff, this rotation there. And I'd probably get out the very, very small star head. Loosen those up so this could rotate a little easier. That's it. Big, thick, stiff, vinyl-feeling, exposed cable guides. Go from one to the other. They're a flawless build. That's hard to say. I've you know, every headphone's got something going on with it. These are just a little stiff there. Other than that, flawless build. The softer pads, I do recommend if you get them, you do swap the pads out. It's not that hard a process. There's a little notch. You peel them off and you find the notch and you spin them with the thing. It'll help guide the flap on there. Oh, hold on. Okay, good, good. Next. It sounds natural. These are marked on the site. We got fun and games. Openback Studio reference headphone for mixing and mastering. Right? And I believe them. I believe these are good enough to master professionally on. You know? Sorry, I'm just enjoying this for a second. I guess they're neutral. I'm trying to, like, take what I'm hearing and put it into a perspective. Because I always talk about the 600s down there. My babies. I painted them, put my logo, 600s, for neutrality. And these are essentially... But they're more than neutral. Because the 1540s, remember the Shure 1540s that I hated? Because they were so boring. Yes, they might have been neutral, but they were boring. And the 600s are neutral, but not boring. And that's where these step in, because these are neutral, but oh my God, not boring. They're exciting. You want to hear things on them. What's the bass like? Well, on the balanced pads, and I got to keep remembering which ones I put where, on the balanced pads, the bass is a little bit laid back. I think these are legitimately the ones you'd be mixing on. Too bad that they're a little bit stiffer, because the comfort does go up like 15% when you put the other pads on. With these pads, the headphones are probably perfect mastering headphones. The end of everything. With the analytical pads on, there's a little more fun to it, just a touch. I don't know what... You tell me the difference between balanced and analytical as far as definitions of headphone terms. Because I'm thinking about it, I'm like, well, aren't you analyzing, wouldn't you want to be balanced and neutral? If you're analytical, wouldn't you be what the fuck are you talking about? So, all I know is the B pads or the A pads. All right, let's just go with that. And I think the A pads, just, they soften up that low end. They bring a warmth to it that I really, really like. And the highs, now we got to talk about Tesla highs, because we have a thing. And they get right up there with some of the best I've heard. One of my more recent reviews was the Audio-Technica A1000Zs, which were $400 and closed. And those have more bass than these, but very similar highs. These highs just are so accurate. I don't know. Here's the deal. I don't know why you'd buy the T1s if these exist. Well, the T1s are still old crop. That's why they were sharp. I think you could tell just by sharp. Are these not sharp? Oh, then they fixed it. Okay. So, granted, we're not talking about entry-level headphones here. Again, $600. And this, I'll go over this now. So, right here, Beyerdynamic, only 7 left in stock, $600 for the 1990 professionals. But then you go and you look in related, and for whatever fucking reason you want to talk about it, and I don't know what it is, and this has been here for months, because when I first got these, this was happening, and I'm like, that's not going to keep going. These headphones, plus a Fio A5, plus a 32 meg micro SD card, plus another headphone case, which is what this guy ordered. All that stuff is in here, by the way. Extra headphone case. Fio A5. 32 meg micro SD card. For no reason. Because this isn't a player. So why are they including this? What's going on here? I don't know who set this bundle up. And I hope it's still there. Because it's $70 cheaper to get all of this instead of just this alone. It's a fucking no-brainer. This alone is like $130. You could get this and then just sell this. And that's $100 less. And I don't know what you do with a 32 gig thing, and I guess you keep the generic. It comes with a case. Why are you getting another case? It doesn't make any sense, this bundle. But the bundle exists, and it saves you some money. Not only does it save you it's $70 less. If it was $70 more than the headphones alone, then you're still saving on the A5 for an amp. Because you do need an amp to drive these if you're going portable. Then again, it only comes with this crazy long cable. So you'd have to buy the AKG cable, which I'll link. But then you could take these portable. How bad do they leak sound? I think in an office, you're going to annoy people. But who cares? Because you own 1990s. So yeah, I'm going to link to that if it's still available, and to the alone for more money. I don't know. Soundstage. It's not colossal. Usually when you talk about monitoring cans, about professional mixing, they hold the soundstage down. They keep it under control. Because it's pretty common if you have very wide soundstage headphones, AKE. Example, the fucking X1s or X2s, those are very wide. Probably some of the widest. And you lose some of the detail because it's moving things further away. You expect stand 200 feet away from speakers, yeah, they're going to sound big, but you also can't hear what's going on. So these keep it in check, not narrow, not R70X. Those were the narrowest headphones. X2s are widest, R70X are the narrowest, followed up closely by the 600s. And these are just a little bit wider sounding than the 600s. They're not ruining anything. I could hear all I'm listening to Pirates of the Caribbean right now, Angelica featuring Rodrigo and Gabriela. And I could tell you the shape of the room that they're playing this in. I could tell how far they were sitting from the microphones. I could tell you everything. Oh. These are some of my favorite headphones of 2016, even though it's 2017, because I've only done a few, and these are still some of my favorite of this year as well. They finally, whatever code needed to be cracked has been cracked. All right, they're not cheap. Again, they're $600. But for what they give you, for how they're built, for what they sound like, it's finally worthwhile to invest in some Beyerdynamics. Finally. I'd gladly add them to my wall, but I've got bigger fish to fry with my wallet. They deserve the praise that they're getting. If they're not getting praise, well, now they should be. They are a little bit hard to drive. I've got them on the X7S Class A headphone amp, the add-on for the X1S. And it's not up near half, but on a very quiet song, I had it like up there. They're only 250 ohm. And most, well, like normally recorded music is fine. Real quiet stuff, you're gonna need that extra power. I'm sort of upset they don't let you go balanced inputs. You'd have to rip this apart and change it over and or add another hole to this side to do balance, but you know, that's just my... God, they're so pretty. The sparkle, just the sparkle on that mesh. This is made in Germany right there. Thank you, Germany. Thank you for finally coming through with, like, I want to say affordable, but it's, you know, $600. Actually, no, it's not $600. It's $530 minus the cost of a FIO A5 and whatever you could sell this and this for. So if you could sell this A5 for full cost and then just, I guess, throw this at someone you don't care about and then just throw that in the garbage, you could save like $100. These would be $400 and something. That's right in the wheelhouse of like every major mid-fi headphone. And this'll take it. If you have the 1770s you want to send them to me, message me on... Don't message me here on YouTube. YouTube sucks for messaging. I have an email account linked to this address. I have Reddit, which I do occasionally check, but it might take a week for me to figure out, you know, what's going on. You could always sign up for the Patreon up there, and then I'll definitely get your message because I read all those obsessively. You could always go to the description, download this wallpaper, because I know you want to. I know you want to. There's also a sound demo down there of these, which will not... I hope I can capture these, what these do, because these do amazing things. It's like the first headphone that, other than maybe the Monoprice monoliths, that is built as well as it sounds and sounds as well as it's built. It's great. I would just seriously say take the balance pads off if you're not actually doing mastering. Try the analyticals, because I think they are just a little bit more for what I like. And who knows, maybe something you like. How's their weight? They're actually pretty hefty. It's metal, but that's like German metal, Tiger Tank metal. But they're comfortable. They've got the standard Behrdynamic comfy pads on here. These are, again, a little bit softer than those, but I wouldn't try to change them. I wouldn't change them out for no reason. God damn. All right, enough with these German headphones. Sound demo description. Have a listen.